Hello and welcome. My name is Andrea Walford, and in today's video, I'm going to show you how to create a simple one-layer card that is suitable for beginning card makers. So the first thing I want to do is to walk you through the supplies that I'm going to be using to create this card. I have here a card base, and this is a 4.25 by 11 inch piece of cardstock that was scored at 5.5 inches and then folded in half using a bone folder to create a nice crisp crease. So we're going to be working on the front of this card. Now you're also going to need a scrap piece of white cardstock, and you can see that I have that here, and it doesn't matter what size your piece is. Next, you're going to need a stamp set. Now the stamp set that I'm choosing is this Field of Flowers stamp set. And one of the reasons that I really like this stamp set is because it has solid image stamps. So you don't need to have any coloring skills at all. The stamps do all the work for you. And then it also has a variety of different greetings that you can use. So this is the only stamp set that we're going to be using. This stamp set does come with a coordinating punch that you can see here. This is called the Confetti Flowers Border Punch, and it coordinates with this floral image that you see here in the Field of Flowers stamp set. Now, in terms of ink colors, I'm going to be using Stampin' Up's Bermuda Bay Classic Ink, Granny Apple Green, Mango Melody, Poppy Parade, and Melon Mambo. Now, in addition to these colored inks, I'm going to be using a black ink, and my favorite black ink for stamping is this Memento Tuxedo Black Ink. Now, other things that you're going to need are an adhesive, and I'm going to be using my Tombow Mono Multi-Liquid Glue. This is the adhesive that I recommend in my essential supplies list for card makers. And then I also have here a grid ruler. It doesn't much matter what size you have. My personal preference, the one that I tend to reach for most often, is this 3 by 12 inch grid ruler. I have a pair of tweezers, a pencil, a white eraser. It doesn't matter which eraser you use, but I quite like this Mono Zero from Tombow because you can see it has a nice fine size and making it easy to get into small areas if you need to erase, but any white eraser will do. I always keep a pair of scissors in case I need it. And then the final thing is an embellishment for the card. And my go-to embellishment, so the first one that I generally recommend that stampers get, is some form of clear rhinestones, or if you don't have rhinestones, sequins. Both of them are great for adding a beautiful, sparkly finishing touch to your cards. So those are all the supplies that we're going to be using to make today's card. So when I'm getting ready to stamp, I always like to put a piece of grid paper on top of my self-healing cutting mat. And you can see that I have this here, and this grid paper is from Stampin' Up. And because I like to work in inches, I have the inches side facing upwards. Now, if you work in centimeters, then you can flip it over and you can see the other side is marked with the centimeter lines. The other thing I like to do to help me prepare is to get all my stamps mounted on the acrylic blocks. So here you can see I have my stamp set, as I showed you earlier. I'm going to be using the Field of Flowers stamp, or the Field Grasses stamp, this long one, and I have that mounted. I have the Six Flower stamp. I'm going to be using the Always sentiment, and I'm going to be combining that with the Love sentiment, and then finally I have the little dragonfly image. Now the reason that I like to pre-mount them on blocks is I find that it saves time once I'm into stamping. I don't like to be fumbling around when I'm in the middle of creating. Now, a quick tip for you, when you're choosing acrylic blocks, try to choose an acrylic block that as closely matches the size of your stamp as you possibly can. That will eliminate the likelihood of misstamped images or ink smears in areas where you don't want. So I'm just going to set everything else aside except for the stamps that I'm going to be using. Now the other thing that I want to mention is I always clean my stamps as I go. That way I don't accidentally end up laying my card or a cardstock piece on top of a messy stamp, or I don't accidentally use a dirty stamp on a different colored ink pad. Now my favorite way to clean my stamps is simply by using baby wipes. So I'm just going to take out one of my baby wipes, and I always look for the unscented baby wipes, and I'm going to set that aside so that's ready to go. So the first thing I'm going to be doing is stamping the Field Grasses stamp along the bottom edge of the front of my card. And I'm going to be doing that in Granny Apple Green. Now notice that my card, if I open it up, it doesn't sit perfectly flat on my grid paper. So what I like to do is to take a little bit of a low tack or low adhesive tape, like washi tape, and I like to hold it in place. So I'm just going to take a little piece of my washi tape, and this is just old washi tape that was in my craft stash. And it's this one has lost a lot of its adhesive over time, but if you have a really sticky washi tape, you can just kind of stick it to the back of your hand, and that'll get rid of some of the adhesive. And then you can just use that to hold your cardstock on either side. And as you can see, what I've done here is I've lined the bottom edge of my card with one of the lines on my grid paper. So this gives me visual reference when I'm stamping to help me make sure that I'm stamping my image straight. Now these ink pads open just by flipping up and then sliding them in. And I never slide them all the way in because I just find it a lot easier to grab when I'm ready to close them. So now if you take a look at this stamp, you can see there's the bottom edge of the stamp over here. Now when you're stamping onto the bottom edge of your card or cardstock piece, you want to make sure that you're actually stamping partially off the cardstock. Otherwise, you could end up with a plain line underneath your image at the bottom of your card, which looks quite unsightly. So I'm just gonna go ahead and ink up my stamp. So as you can see, I have my stamp facing up and I'm pressing my ink pad onto my stamp. It's always easier when you have a stamp that's bigger than an ink pad to ink the stamp with the ink pad rather than taking your stamp and pressing it onto the ink pad. So now, as you can see, when I flip my block over, I can see right through my block. And this is why I recommend the clear photopolymer stamps for beginning stampers, because it's very easy to see where you want your image placed. Now, one of the things you're going to have to do, of course, is to look directly above the stamp so you can see where it's being positioned. So I'm going to do this off camera because I don't want you to have to watch the back of my head, and then I'll come back and stamp. So now I've carefully figured out the alignment of my stamp. So I want to make sure that it goes over both the left and right edges and slightly below the bottom. And then I'm going to press straight down and straight up. And you can see that I positioned it perfectly because there's no extra white space along the bottom. So now, as I mentioned, I'm just going to clean my stamp and then I'm going to set it aside. Now, a quick tip for you, if you're making lots of cards, in order to speed up the process, it's helpful to do each step for the entire set of cards one at a time. So if I was going to do 5 cards exactly the same, I would do this step for all 5 of my cards before moving on to the next step. So next, what I want to do is to stamp my greeting. So I'm going to be stamping this always. Now, here's the thing. When you're stamping on to your cardstock like this, it's very hard to see if you're going to be stamping your image straight. You have to have a really good eye for that. And although I generally have a good eye, there's times that I miss. And then I end up having to start all over again and waste my card because I have a crooked image, because I really don't like to give cards with crooked images. It just takes away from the finished effect of the card. So this is where having a pencil and a ruler comes in. What I like to do is to take my ruler, and I like to draw a very faint pencil line that I can use as a guide to stamp my image. So I'm going to hold my block over my card so that I can get a sense of where I want to stamp it, how high I want it to be. And then I align the edge of my ruler with the lines in my grid paper. So this is looking pretty good, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 grid marks. So that would be basically 1 3/4 inches. So let me just check if that's good. And that does look like a good height. So 1¾ inches up from the bottom of my card, I'm going to draw a very faint line. You do not want to apply pressure because otherwise you'll have the indentation of the pencil line on your card front. So you can see there, I have my line. So now if you look at the sentiment, let me just bring back the cover here. You can see this is in a script font and the letters are at different heights. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to try to align the bottom of the W and the bottom of the S with my line. So once again, because my stamp is bigger than my ink pad, and plus I just find it easier to see and make sure my stamp is well inked, if I flip my stamp upwards and then pat my ink pad all over it. So I like to press and tap my ink pad and then take a look to make sure that it's well inked and that there's no little stray bits of fluff. So now I'm once again going to align the bottom of the S and the W with this line. So that looks pretty good. So I'm going to go straight down, apply some gentle pressure, lift straight up, and you can see my perfectly stamped greeting. My W and my S are on the line. Now, you don't want to rush into erasing your line right away because if your ink is not perfectly dry, and it does dry pretty quickly, but you just never know sometimes, you run the risk of smudging the ink and having to start all over. So I always leave that as one of my last steps. Now, my sentiment that I'm using, or the accompanying greeting, is love. And because it's quite small, it tucks here above the A very nicely. If you want to use some of the other greetings, then you might have to think of different placements on or around your sentiment. So for example, if you want to use the my friend, you might want my friend always, and you could perhaps stamp my friend just above the always. If you want, let's say, always thinking of you is quite large. So I might just leave the always in the front because you can see I have the dot, 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 and then stamp the thinking of you on the inside of my card. So that's just a couple tips for you, depending on what sentiment you want to use. Now, once again, I want to draw a line that I can use as a guide just above the A. So I'm going to use my pencil and ruler again. And this is where having a grid ruler comes in handy because you can see here my grid ruler. So my big lines here are marked at 1/2 inch, but I have these little lines at 1/8 inch increments. So if I want my stamp to be just a little bit above the A, what I can do is I can use my ruler, these little increments, as a guide to tell me how much I want my ruler above the A. Now in this case, just to make sure I get it straight, I'm starting off a little bit lower than I want and I've aligned the edges of my ruler with the lines on my grid paper and then I'm very carefully trying to keep it straight, going to slide upwards. And then I'm just going to lightly draw my pencil line. And you can see that that's a good height above the A. So next, I'm going to once again take my black ink and I'm going to ink up my love. I'm going to align it with my line. See, this time now, because my stamp is small, it's easier for me to press my stamp on my ink pad. But I always like to flip it over and take a look to make sure that it's well inked. Then I'm going to, once again, align it and stamp. So now that I know my sentiment is where I want it to be, I'm gonna go ahead and stamp. And because this is small, my head's probably gonna get in the way because I really wanna make sure I don't shift it at all. And there you go, perfect. So now I'm just going to get my black ink pad out of the way and make sure my greeting stamps are clean. So now I want to add another detail to my card and that is the little dragonfly. What I'm going to do is I'm going to use my Bermuda Bay Classic ink. I'm gonna ink up my stamp on my ink pad and I'm gonna stamp my first dragonfly. I'm going to stamp like he's flying away here. And then without inking my stamp again, I'm going to stamp him over here. Now that technique is called stamping off. And basically you see I got two stamped images, but I only inked my stamp once. And what that allows me to do is to get a tone on tone effect. So this is my ink color full strength, and this is my ink color stamped off. You can see it's a lighter shade of this one. And it kind of helps give the impression that your butterfly, that your dragonfly is a little bit further away. So now we can very carefully take off our tape here. I'm gonna actually leave it attached. I just wanna take it off my grid paper. And I'm going to set my card aside and we're going to punch some flowers that we're gonna decorate the field grasses with. So I have here my scrap of Whisper White cardstock and I'm going to be stamping and punching my flowers in three colors. I've got Melon Mambo, I've got Poppy Parade, and I have Mango Melody. So a yellow, a red, and a pink. I've got my baby wipe handy too to clean my stamp in between. So I'm going to stamp my lightest color first. Now before I do that, I'm going to take a look at my stamp and I'm going to take a look at the coordinating punch. So this, as I mentioned, is called the Confetti Flowers Border Punch. Now whenever I'm punching out an image that I've stamped, I don't just stick it in here because I need to make sure it aligns with the windows, which is what I call these little pieces here of my punch. So before I stamp my flower, I like to take a look at the window and make sure I'm stamping it in the correct orientation. So you can see right now, if I were to stamp this in this orientation, I'd be actually stamping upside down and then I'd have to cut my scrap paper to be able to actually punch this out. So I'm gonna make sure that I flip my flower so that it's facing in the same orientation as my punch. I'm then going to ink my stamp on the Mango Melody. And I'm going to stamp it as close to the edge of my scrap piece of paper as I can. And then I'm just going to right away clean my stamp so that it's ready to go when I'm ready to use my next color. So now, I'm going to take my flowers, I'm just going to push my ink pads a little bit out of the way, and I'm going to take my flowers and I'm going to align it in my punch. Now if you see here that, let's say you haven't punched close enough to the edge, then what you can simply do is use your scissors to just trim a little bit closer to the stamped image to make it easier for you to punch it out. So what I'm going to do now, you can see here, I'm fiddling with the orientation of my image in my punch because I want to get all these little flowers lined up in the windows of my punch. And I'm holding my punch partially depressed so that once I get it in the right spot, I can push down enough that I'm holding my paper in place. So you can see here, my paper's not sliding. Now, if I were to just punch like this, my flowers would pop up and scatter everywhere. So I like to flip this upside down. I'm still holding it in place though, and I'm punching. And you can see here, I now have all my flowers. So I'm just gonna go ahead and repeat this process using my other two colors. I've got my Poppy Parade and my Melon Mambo. So here you can see I have all my flowers punched out. Now just one quick thing that I wanted to mention. If you find when you're using an ink color that the color is too strong when you're stamping, you can always stamp off. So the same technique we did with the dragonflies. You can see for these flowers here, I stamped it in the Melon Mambo Classic ink, but I find it a little bit too dark. It's too close to the Poppy Parade. I wanted more of a contrast between the flowers. So I stamped off once and then stamped it again and punched it out. And you can see here that I have a lighter tone of flowers, but in that same pink shade. You really get the pink more out of these flowers. So now that I have my flowers, I'm going to bring back my card and using that washi tape, I'm just going to hold it in place and I'm going to be using my Tombow Mono Multi-Liquid Glue to stick my flowers down. And this is where having a set of fine tipped tweezers come in. Now I really like these tweezers. These are, I think it's a Cutterby brand. I just got it at my local big box craft store and you can see it has a very fine tip and it actually holds closed and to open it, you have to press it, which is good. So with traditional tweezers, it's the other way around. You have to press it to hold it closed. But with these tweezers, you can see I can pick something up and it's not gonna fall out of my tweezers. So before I actually stick them down, what I want to do is to just position my flowers just to get kind of a general idea of where I want my flowers to be. Now keep in mind, they don't necessarily have to be exactly on the grass, although I like to keep it as close to the grass as I can, but I'm trying to kind of scatter them around so that you really kind of get the effect of a bright field with lots of flowers. Now with this step, you don't want to overthink it. You basically just kind of grab and put down. I mean, I think about it a little bit in the sense that I don't want flowers all of the same color, all clustered together. So I want to make sure there's a bunch of different flowers, but I'm not spending time agonizing over my choices. So once I have a general idea of where I want my flowers, it's now time to stick them down. So there's a couple ways you could do this when you're working with liquid glue. You have to be very careful that you don't get a big squish of liquid glue out of the tip. So I'll show you three different ways that I do this. Sometimes I will take a flower and I will just very gently squeeze my glue. So I have a little bead of glue at the end and then I'll just touch it to my flower. So you can see I have my glue there. You don't want tons of glue because otherwise when you put it down, it will squish around the edges of the flower and you'll see it on your card. If you find, because sometimes with the glue pens, a lot of glue comes out, and if you find you're consistently having that problem, you can always put a little bit onto a scrap piece of cardstock and you can grab a toothpick. Let's see if I can get one out here. And then you can apply a little bit of glue to the end of your toothpick, like so. Grab your flower and then just dab some glue on the back of your flower using a toothpick. And then you get just the right amount of glue. The other way you can do it, now with this one, with this way, I don't squeeze really at all. So I'll squeeze ahead of time and then I'll let go. So I have a little bit of glue at the tip and then I'll very gently touch it to my card. Now, this method is probably the riskiest. And if you have a brand new tube of glue, you don't want to do it this way. So I'm just going to go ahead and glue the rest of these down. There's no need for you to watch me doing the whole thing. And once I'm done, I will be back. Whoops. So there you can see I have attached all but three of my flowers, and how many or how few you put, that's totally a matter of personal preference. So before I do my final step of adding a few rhinestones, it's now time to get rid of my pencil line. So I'm going to use my white eraser, and I always like to make sure that my tip is not dirty, because if you have dirt on your tip, it can transfer to your card. So I'll always just erase a little bit on my paper. And then very gently, I'm just going to erase my pencil lines. Now you do have to make sure as you're doing this and when you get close to the edge that you're very gentle, because you don't want to accidentally pull up your cardstock if you're moving in the wrong direction. So now my final step is going to be to add my rhinestones. Now here's a tip for you when you're adding rhinestones. These rhinestones are self-adhesive. These ones are from Stampin' Up. They're the older packaging. They have a new packaging now so that their new ones don't come with these strips of rhinestones. But I have so many of these ones, I want to use these up first. Now they're self-adhesive, meaning there's an adhesive on the back of them. So what I like to do is to very carefully take a rhinestone and I'll lay it onto my card, but I don't actually stick it down yet. So I don't press it in place. I just lay it lightly, because I find that usually what happens is that I spend quite a bit of time fiddling with the placement of my rhinestones. I don't always know where I want my rhinestones to be. So if you just lightly place it on your card, the adhesive doesn't get stuck to the paper and you have the opportunity to rearrange your rhinestones. So you can see here, if I want this down a little bit, I can just take my tweezers and I can nudge it downwards. Now, when adding embellishments to your card, just a quick design tip, keeping things in threes or in odd numbers is more pleasing than having an even number. And the other thing is you can think about how you want the person's eye to move. So for example, they're probably, you know, generally they might move as they're looking at the card this way. So the rhinestones are kind of guiding the eye in the direction that I want people to look. Once you're happy with the placement of your rhinestones, then you just press it down to make sure they stay in place. So we can now go ahead and very carefully remove our washi tape. And there you can see we're finished our card. Now, if you want to, you can go ahead and stamp a sentiment on the inside, or you can just leave it plain so that you can handwrite whatever it is you want to say. Well, I hope you found this video tutorial helpful and that it's given you some tips and tricks, as it was intended to help beginning card makers get the hang of how to start creating cards.